Hello friends of the Northern Entertainment and welcome to another episode of Train Sim World 2. Let's have a look here quickly. We are to unlock the doors, so we're gonna do that quickly before we're gonna get to the main event. There we go. And that is, I'm gonna use the Long Island Railroad here, this EMU. To show you something that I can show you if you want, and let me know in the comments below if you would like that. But remember how in the last episode I was talking about how we can essentially drive every train on every line without the head-up display for the most part if we only use the systems that we have in-game available. So that being said, let's turn the headlights on here. And we have to wait for another 15 seconds, so that gives us enough time. So on this train, it's fairly easy. You go click for the ATC. You go the alerter cutout. Deadman's cutout. And that's it for this train. So we can sit down. Now we can lock the doors. And unlike protocol, we're gonna leave the key in here. Master key on, and you can see here all this stuff lighting up now, and this makes this train really easy to run. In 10 miles in Jamaica, we are having our next stop. We're gonna turn our marker lights off. We're gonna turn the headlights to bright, the reverser to forward, brakes go setting max brake, and now we're gonna click charging until we reach 90. There. Now we can charge the brake system up until we reach 90 psi, and that will release the brakes for our train. You can see that here, and now we can move our lever and roll on out. And you might be like, but Alex, don't you see? You still have a HUD. Yes, yes, I see that. And now you see how the ATC system works. We're going to turn this off because points are just that, whatever. But what we want today is realistic train operation. Or don't get me wrong, I am not a professional by any stretch of the imagination. But I do know my way around enough on railways or on the virtual railways to drive without, without to drive without HUD. And the reason that I chose the Long Island Railroad, the LIRR EMU, is because the ATC system on this is relatively advanced, fairly advanced, and it's fairly easy to use. Once the speed drops, you wanna, of course, go. And I'm gonna demonstrate that here. So we are driving. And you can go right up to the speed limit. Once you hit the speed limit, you will get an overspeed warning. Now, as long as you have only the warning, and I'm going to show you guys, I'm going to go there. See, now we have the warning. Now you have to make a decided brake application. So you have the ATC 4-star on. And as long as that one is on, everything will be good. You hit Q, you acknowledge that you had the overspeed warning, and you can just keep on going. And if the speed would drop right now, then we do the same thing. We're just gonna decelerate. We're gonna take We're gonna take our lever into the brake application and we're just gonna hit the brakes until the point where we slow down enough and we can just keep on we can just keep on doing what we do here. And as I said, if we get into this realm of having a penalty flash or a penalty show up, then all we have to do is hit Q to acknowledge that, and then you really want to slow down, because if you do not, if you fail to acknowledge it and or fail to slow down, then you will get into the penalty section, and that unfortunately then will show you very quickly that this train has a very good functioning brake system and you will have an emergency brake application. So that being said, we have also signals here, and again, this is not a professional tutorial from a real life railroader. I tried to run prototypical within reason, and I tried to explain it to you in such a way that you will understand it. I'm not gonna bombard you with all the special terminology yet. If you want, I can make a video about that as well, though. Because I have... Oh, there we go. Just hit V and get the wipers going. But basically, whenever you... At least on Western railroads, whenever you have a signal on this side, this is the signal that's of interest for you. As long as you have a green on top, everything is good. Clear shot ahead. When you have yellow or red, well, red obviously means stop no matter what, and a yellow, well, it can have many different meanings depending on what it's combined with. If it's yellow with yellow over green, if it's yellow over red, if it's there's many different versions or aspects that the signals can show. But if you are really interested in that, then I can make a video about that one as well. You just have to let me know. And B, there's also very good documentation available in the internet about the different railroads. You just pretty much have to look up the railroad that you are looking at, because every railroad really has their own little ways of doing things. The Long Island Railroad, for example, uses a mixture out of normal light aspects as well as a little bit of the sophomore Now we're gonna go downhill a little bit, so we wanna make sure we don't speed. I tried to stay within 5 miles, plus minus. Not plus in this case, because the speed control is very, very unforgiving. You go 1 mile over and you are getting your overspeed alert. And as I said, if you don't slow down significantly and very decisively, then you might end up with a major brake application. So here we have yellow over green. And that means that we are going on a diverging track. So I'm gonna, usually when I see yellow over green, I am slowing down to 45 miles an hour minimum. It might not have been the case this time though. Let's see what we got here. Yeah, see, this aspect shows us it's good to go. Yeah. free to go up to line speed 60 miles per hour. You can tell we have a pretty long train. And we are cleared for 80 miles per hour. Now there's absolutely nothing wrong if you want to make sure that you don't gonna overshoot. If you quickly look, okay, we're 4.8 miles away. Now it's a little bit more difficult here to tell where you are. I don't know exactly how the sign system works on the Long Island Railroad system, to be honest with you. It's a little bit easier, for example, on a German track, because you have every 200 meters you have a signage that shows you which kilometer you are on, and based on that you can very easily figure out how much longer it is to your station. Like, for example, you are at 66.6 and it's declining from where you're going. So, you know, 10 kilometers is your station. Well, at 60, I would start slowing down at, let's say, 57. Because at 66, you have to be coming to a stop. At 56, you have to be coming to a stop. And how much more interesting is this all going to be once we have, a rush hour, where we have to deal with all those different passengers and the amount of passengers. I mean, right now it's fairly easy peasy. There's not much going on the rail, but once you introduce more traffic, more passengers, more things that can go wrong, then it will be very interesting indeed. 2.5 miles until we have to slow down, so at this point I am not going to accelerate anymore. In fact, I am going to slow down ever so slightly, because we have a fairly long train, and of course with a fairly long train comes also that you are fairly heavy. On top of that, keep in mind that the track, or the rails right now, this is steel, and it is wet steel. And if you ever put wet steel on wet steel and try to slow down, well, you are in for a nasty surprise. So I'm just gonna take it very casually here I'm gonna take it very slowly here towards the station. And I'm pretty sure that once we get closer to the station, like within a mile and a half, probably at the next signal already, it's gonna slow us down anyway. So we'll see how this is all gonna go. Let's see, what do we have here still? Oh, they still don't slow us down. Interesting. That might change at the next signal, though. Let's see. There you have now. See how I had to slow down into that forestall, or until ATC forestall was activated, and then when I hit acknowledge, well, that's when I indeed can, or basically they want to make sure that I have indeed seen the signal change, and there is the signal change that caused it all. So that tells us that the next signal is a red one. And we are now at 27 miles per hour, so we don't have to worry about the overspeed or overspeed penalty. As you can see, we are indeed rolling downhill though, which of course means that the train will pick up speed. And we definitely do not want to be much faster than we are right now, because we are coming to a stop here right away. ...23 miles is a nice ginger speed to just roll into the station here. And here you can see we are now slowed down to 15 miles per hour. And stop. Here we are. Now it wants us to unlock doors. Well, this is the interesting part. We can't do that from here. Have to do this here. Put our key in and unlock the rearward doors. Just like that. Friends, I think you get the idea now. And yeah, with this very simple train, it was very easy to show you that it is indeed possible to drive without HUD. In the next episode, then we will go that very final step where I'm gonna show you guys how to run with all systems activated without a HUD. And on top of that, on a German track, we will be using a track book, and that will make it a lot easier for us to determine what the next speed change is, and so on and so forth. I hope you enjoyed this episode and you will join me again next time when we are back in Train Sim World 2. Until then, this is the Northern Alex signing off. Thank you so much for watching. God bless.